Hello, everybody. This episode is about risk management. Risk management is a new application added to the Odoo Openinside platform. Risk management is a highly needed function to manage challenges consistently in one system, where all the risks can be seen and managed within one system. This friendly and comprehensive application provides the ability to ensure the operational, financial, strategic, and reputational risks are seen and managed in one single application to provide the consistent, systematic, and holistic opportunity to manage the entire risk of any organization. So this application provides a comprehensive solution towards capturing the events, identifying the risks, developing the risk assessment, including the risk evaluation analysis, and providing the treatments required to reduce the risk level. Not to mention, it provides a robust follow-up for the approval of the risk assessments and the risk treatments or actions. Plus, it provides built-in reports, an endless reports option required by the board, executive, insurance partners, and whomever. Therefore, the organization can show a high level of commitment and solidarity to the shareholders, lenders, and insurance companies through this application. Let us now show you the application. Clicking the risk management icon would allow us to see the menu. So the menu consists from four options: events, risks, reports, and configuration. The events menu provides the opportunity to create or list the events activities that were made previously. The risk menu provides the opportunity to enter the details of the risks and risk assessment, as well as to list all the risks that were made previously. The reports menu provides the opportunity to generate built-in reports such as list of risk, risk dashboard, and risk profile for whatever levels, whether it was for all, board, executive, and department. In addition, there could be an option to create whatever reports, whether it is an interactive or PDF. And finally, clicking the configuration menu allows us to amend any settings to suit the organization convenience. Now we'll start with the event. Clicking the event section will allow us to see this screen actually. So let me now click into create. When I click into create, it allows me to basically put whatever details within the event section. So I can put the title of that event, the detail, the department, if it's related to one department, and also whatever risk under that event. So I can just click into add line and I put the risk title, the department related, the category related, and if there is any tag. Now let me show you a previously made events. Let me now click into COVID-19. So when I click here, I click also edit, it will allow me to edit or enter any fields. So here we can see the title of that event, which is COVID-19, the detailed, okay, and the two risks under that event, the shortage of workforce, the department related administration, the operation as a category of that risk, and the tag which is COVID-19. The other risk is the supply chain. The department is the professional services. The category is operational, and the tag is COVID-19 as well. Also, I can just click into add line and put whatever risk related to that specific event. Very good. Now let's go to the detail of that risk assessment. Now you can see from the page of the event that each of those risks that were added under that event, there is an an icon which is in front of it related to the risk assessment. It just says here, open assessment form. So this will be related to the shortage of workforce. The other will be related to the supply chain impact. So if I click into the first one, this will take me to the risk assessment form related to the COVID-19 shortage of workforce. And from here, I can put the details of that risk assessment in terms of the title, in terms of the title of the risk, and the detail of the risk, plus the version and the version date, and the other detailed, such as the department, risk owner, category, and the tag. Okay, from here, there are two options I can edit for each of those risks. The first one related to the risk analysis, and the second one related to the risk evaluation. Okay, let's now go to the risk analysis. And here there are three sections related to the risk analysis: the number of contributing factors, which are basically the causes of that risk, the current control, the current available for that risk, and the risk treatment, which are basically the action that was decided to reduce the risk. Now, let me show you how to create any of those lines. So if I just put add line, this will take me to a new page where I can put the main causes, okay? And from there, I can put the control available to control that cause or causes, and the risk treatment, okay, related. So I can put the detail of that risk treatment, the target date, okay, the status, whether it's open, in progress, or close, and the risk owner, okay, if it was added previously, or I can put another risk owner action if that action is related to another personnel. And here, there are two icons, one's related to save and close and save and new. If I just click and save and close, so this will save me this screen, but if I put save and new, this will take me to a new screen where I can put another contributing factor. So if I just click into this card, okay, this will show me the previously edited detailed. So if I click in any one of them, okay, this will show me the detail put previously. So for instance, this contributing factor, which is related to lack of adherence to hygiene prevention, okay, the risk current control is basically implementation of work from home policy. The risk treatment is basically issue enforcement penalties. And here I put the target date, the status, okay, the owner. Now the owner, if it's blank, this will be related to the risk assessment owner. And I will just click into save. It will take me to this page. Okay, so this is basically related to the risk analysis, where most of the details of that risk were actually put. Now let's go to the final section within that risk assessment by going to the evaluation section. And here we will evaluate the risk from three angles: the severity impact, the likelihood, probability, and the control effectiveness. Let us now see how we do the risk evaluation. If we just click into the severity impact, this will open for me a screen where this will show me the risk severity criteria in terms of the score, rating, color, EHS, health, environment, health and safety, the cost, and also the reputation. Now, this was based in one organization. However, this is highly configurable, and this could be related to a symmetrical or asymmetrical risk assessment. Plus, this allows me to evaluate that risk from three levels: the inherent risk, the current risk, and the residual risk. The inherent risk is basically the evaluation of the risk, considering that there's no current control. The current risk, however, is evaluation of the risk, considering the current control. And the residual risk is basically the evaluation of the risk, considering that all the risk treatment or the actions suggested were actually implemented. Let's see how this is it could be evaluated. If I just click into this arrow, I can choose whatever level from 1 to 5. This will be the same for the current risk as well as the residual risk. Plus, I can put whatever justification for whomever would like to basically review it, whether it could be an editor, an auditor, okay, or senior management. And then I just click into save. In the same way, I will go to the likelihood section, and it will show me the criteria which was previously built in, and it will show me the three levels of risk that I can evaluate in terms of the inherent risk, current risk, and residual risk. And simply by doing the same, I just choose the levels from 1 to 5 and click into save. From doing so, the system will basically calculate for me the risk score. So we can see now here the inherent risk as very high, the current risk is medium, and the residual risk is also medium. The third angle of evaluation is basically the control effectiveness. And here I'm evaluating the risk in terms of the effectiveness of the current control to control the risk, which is basically available right now. And the criteria is basically being built and shown in the screen from 1 to 5, from highly ineffective with this detail to enable the risk owner or whomever to choose the correct rating, okay, to effective. So this can be also done easily. Just click into this arrow and it will allow me to choose the levels from 1 to 5. Once this is done, I can just press save. By doing so, I save all the information for that risk assessment. And here we can see now the workflow for that risk assessment from draft, risk owner approval, manager approval, and the approval. Very good. So by doing so, we put all the detail for that specific risk assessment. Now we can see in the upside the workflow for the approval, okay, and the status for the risk assessment. So now we can see it is now right now as a draft, okay. It will take me to the risk owner, the manager approval, okay, and approval. So this risk assessment workflow is based on one of the structure given previously for one organization. However, the risk assessment flow can be changed in terms of priority for that risk and in terms of the organization structure. Excellent. Now we go to the third mini option, which is reports. And here there are three options of the report, whether it is a list of risk, risk dashboard, or risk profile. Okay, not only that, there are also another option for each of those options. We can generate reports for all risk, for board risk, for executive risk, for the department, okay, or for the board approved. Okay, we can do the same for the risk dashboard and also the risk profile. The third option also, we can generate reports for, say, risk dashboard, for the board, or for the executive, whatever, and also for a specific risk level, whether it is inherent risk, or current risk, or residual risk. Now, let me show you some of the examples. Let me choose list of risk all. This will show me the reports, an interactive one, for all the risks that were generated previously, the risk titles, the inherent risk evaluation, the current risk evaluation, the residual risk evaluation that was chosen previously, the risk, the department related, and the status of that risk, whether it is draft or approved, and whether it is board related or not. Let me see another report. Let me see the risk dashboard for executive. And here, this should show me a very interactive report where all the risk dashboard executive are shown in terms of the title, description, risk owner, evaluation of the risk, risk inherent, current, residual, risk treatment, and also the treatment target, treatment status, plus a comment can be put in the last to justify that specific action. The third interesting report called risk profile. This is a very interesting report where actually one single page represents the entire risk for that specific field. Let me choose, say, the executive. Let me choose the risk type, say, inherent. As I said, you can choose inherent, current, or residual. Let me generate that risk profile. And here, this is a one-page summary for all executive high-level risk, which is basically represented by one page. And this is basically plotted on the risk matrix. So here we can see the those major risks, okay, and we can see the number, which is basically described into the left-hand side. Not only that, the circle diameter represents the control effectiveness. So the wider the circle, the weaker is the control, okay, the smaller is the better control. So if I click each of those circles, this will take me to the detailed of that specific risk. It's really honestly very interesting. So by that, we conclude the report section. Finally, let me show you the configuration option that is available within this application. And here we can do a lot of setting by just clicking a button. So I can do a configuration in terms of criteria, in terms of the event activity, okay, or even from the department structure. So here I can just click severity, and this will allow me to do a configuration for the criteria for risk evaluation, for the likelihood, for the control effectiveness, and so on. Okay, not only that, if I would like to do more configuration, I can go to the Odoo menu and I just click into settings. In the setting, I go to the risk management option and I can choose the system of the risk matrix, whether symmetrical or asymmetric. I can choose the risk default type, whether it is inherent, current, or residual. Okay, and so on. So you can see now the configuration is made so easily, and this can be done by non-IT guy, by the risk management administrative officer, okay, within just click of a button. By doing so, we just illustrated now the risk management application, which is newly added to the Odoo platform. Thank you very much for being with me. That's all about risk management.